It is one of the biggest debates in photography, full frame versus crop sensor. Do you need a full frame camera to be a professional photographer, or do you need full frame at all? If you have a crop sensor camera, should you upgrade? Do you get more background blur with a full frame camera? Today, I'm going to answer all of these questions for you so you can make your decision on which camera to use for your type of photography. Obviously, the main difference between a full frame sensor and a crop sensor is the size of the sensor, hence the terms full frame and crop sensor. But when you look at the whole picture, things can get a lot more complicated. But the first thing that you have to understand when you learn the differences between the crop sensor and a full frame is the crop factor. The size of a full frame sensor is 36mm by 24mm, the exact 3:2 ratio. And these aren't just some random numbers that someone came up with, it's actually exactly the same size as the 35mm 135 films that were used in film cameras. And that has again become the standard sensor size for digital photography. And crop sensor sizes are not as standardized, so the sizes may vary between different manufacturers. But in most cases, it's 24mm by 16mm. Again, the same ratio, but just slightly smaller. So if you do the math, a full frame sensor is exactly 1.5 times wider and 1.5 times taller. I know this is a lot to take in, but that's one number you have to remember, 1.5. We call this the crop factor. And just to make things a little more complicated, on a Canon camera, Canon crop sensors are slightly smaller than most, so the crop factor on a Canon crop sensor camera is 1.6. So here's what that means in real life. When you attach a lens to a camera, what that lens does is it basically projects an image into the camera onto the rectangular sensor. And a little bit of the top and the bottom and the sides get cropped off, and this is the image that you see when you take a photo on the back of your camera. And now when you attach that same lens onto a crop sensor camera, the image that gets projected into the camera is exactly the same. It's the same lens on the same lens mount. But because the sensor is a lot smaller, a lot more image gets cropped off from the top and the bottom and the sides, and your image looks like this. To demonstrate this, I took a photo with my 50mm lens on a full frame camera and it looked like this. And then from the same spot with the same lens, I took the photo again on my crop sensor camera and it looked like this. It just looks like the image is more zoomed in. So remember the crop factor? So what's really happening here is when you're using a 50mm lens on a crop sensor camera, you multiply 50 with your crop factor, which is 1.6 in this case because I'm using a Canon camera. So here my 50mm lens is actually behaving more like an 80mm lens on my crop sensor camera. So for example, if you have a 100mm lens, that becomes a 160mm lens on a crop sensor camera. So if you have a Canon crop sensor camera, it might have came with a kit lens like the 18-55. And even though it says 18-55 on the lens, on that camera, this lens is more like 28-88mm. So that's the main thing that you have to understand about the crop factor. And this actually provides two benefits when using a crop sensor camera, because if you're someone who likes to photograph something that's generally far away, like wild animals or sports or, I don't know, the moon, longer telephoto lenses can be very expensive, so having that extra reach can be very useful. So if you have a 300mm lens, that lens on a Canon crop sensor camera actually becomes more like 480mm. And it can also be useful when you're shooting macro photos, because when you're shooting something far away, you can always buy a longer lens as long as you can afford it. But for macro photos, you can only get so close to the subject, so having that extra reach can be very, very useful. And the second subject that we need to cover is background blur. And this can be a very tricky subject because there are so many variables between different lenses and different manufacturers. I guess the main question that everyone wants to know the answer for is, do you get more background blur with a full frame camera? And the simple answer for that is yes, but probably not the way you think. The size of the sensor itself actually does not determine the amount of background blur, because as I demonstrated before, the image that gets projected into the camera by the lens is exactly the same because it's the same lens on the same lens mount. That does not change. And if you compare the two images that I took with the same lens from the same distance, the crop sensor camera's image looks exactly like the midsection of the image from the full frame sensor. And here's where things get a little more complicated. Because of the crop factor, to mimic the focal length of 50mm on a full-frame camera with a crop sensor camera, we need something like a 31mm lens. And because there's no such thing, let's say I use a 35mm lens. And if you compare the two images, one from a full-frame camera and one taken with a crop sensor camera with the equivalent focal length, even at the same aperture, you will notice that the background blur is not exactly the same. Because what you're really doing is not changing your 35mm lens into a 50mm lens, you're actually just taking the photo of a midsection of a 35mm lens photo on a full frame camera with a crop sensor camera. So in terms of distance to the subject, it may feel very similar, because as some of you may remember from my portrait focal length video, even when you're keeping the subject as exactly the same size in your frame, when you're using different focal lengths, the effect of it can be very different. So that is why the photo taken with a 50mm lens on a full frame camera will never be the same as the photo taken with a 35mm lens on a crop sensor camera. And there's one thing you can do to compensate this, and that is to multiply your crop factor to the aperture. So for example, if I want to mimic the photo that I took with my full frame camera with an 85mm lens at 1.8, and to get the similar effects, I need something like a 56mm 1.2, because 1.2 times 1.5 is 1.8. And to make the math a little simpler, if you have an image taken at 160mm at f6 on a full frame camera, to get the same effect on a crop sensor camera, you need a 100mm lens and shoot it at f4. And because of the reasons I explained, and because all lenses and cameras are different, you'll never get the exact same photo, but this is the closest that you'll get with a crop sensor camera. So here's when that statement of getting more background blur on a full frame camera becomes true. Because most professional lenses are designed to be used on a full frame camera, if you want a lens with bigger aperture, you have that option. For example, like the 85mm 1.2. To get the similar effects on a crop sensor camera, you need a 56mm 0.8, and there's just no such lens. And if it exists, it would be like $5,000. So if your goal is just to get more background blur, although the bigger sensor itself may not be the reason you get more background blur, but you get a lot more lens selection to be able to do that. So to summarize that, even though you don't necessarily need a bigger sensor to be a professional photographer, most camera manufacturers will always make more professional lenses targeted for full frame cameras. So that's one thing you would have to consider when choosing your camera system. And another advantage of using a full frame camera is noise and low light performance. And this isn't as relevant as it used to be, because the sensor technology has advanced so much over the past few years. But if you compare a crop sensor camera and a full frame camera with the same technology and the same resolution from the same time period, you will notice that the full frame sensor will always perform better in low light. It's a simple physics really, because if you have the same amount of pixels on two different sizes of sensors, on the bigger sensor, the size of the pixels will be obviously a lot bigger. And because of that, a full frame sensor can gather a lot more light than a crop sensor from the same amount of exposure. So you'll notice in most cases, images from a full frame camera will always have less noise, and in low light situations, full frame cameras will perform a lot better. Think of them as solar panels. Obviously, a bigger solar panel will always perform better than a small solar panel because it can gather more light. It's the same idea. So one thing that we haven't talked about yet is the price and the practicality of the two cameras. Not everyone who takes photos are professional photographers, just like how not everyone who plays basketball or golf are professional athletes. And not even professional photographers make money from all the photos that they take. And full frame sensors, because they're bigger, they cost more to manufacture, they cost more to sell, they cost more to buy. And in most cases, full frame lenses are always more expensive than crop sensor lenses. So you have to ask yourselves, what are you going to use your photos for, and will anybody notice that extra bit of background blur and less noise in your photos? Would anybody look down on you because you're using a crop sensor camera? And another thing you have to remember is, because full frame sensors are larger, full frame cameras in general are a lot larger than crop sensor cameras. Here's a bit of an extreme example, but here's my 5D Mark IV, which is a full frame camera, And here's my SL2, which is a crop sensor camera. This is actually one of the smallest DSLRs that Canon makes. And even just the body only, 5D Mark IV is almost 2 times heavier and it's a lot bigger. And not only that, most full frame lenses are also a lot bigger than crop sensor lenses as well. Take a look at this lens. This is a Canon 85mm 1.2, and this is an extremely large and heavy lens. Look at the size of the glass there, look at that. And here's my 56mm 1.2, and this is the 85mm equivalent on a crop sensor camera. And look at the difference between the size, the video just does not do the justice. Look at this, this might be a good thumbnail for my next comparison. So you get the idea. So to summarize this video, if you have a crop sensor camera, always remember the crop factor when buying a new lens. And do you get more background blur with a full frame sensor? Yes, but not because of the sensor, but because of the lens selection. And full frame cameras generally perform better in low light, and crop sensor cameras generally perform better for shooting things that are far away or really close. Think carefully about if the minor differences in the background blur and the noise performance will be worth the extra money and the size and the weight. And if you are someone who's more serious about learning photography or taking your photography to the next level, think about what lens you might be using the most for your type of photography. Are you going to be using long telephoto lenses to shoot wildlife and sports? Or are you going to be shooting landscapes with super wide angles? Or are you going to be shooting portraits with fast primes? Or low light or night photography? So I hope this video will provide you enough information to make that decision. And if you think I missed something or if you have additional questions, feel free to leave a comment. And that's going to be it for me today. And thank you for watching, as always. Bye-bye.